Greetings and welcome back, Dapplings, to the town of Dapperton in Rimworld, where Keegan is just about to finish this first small silver sculpture. Let's pick that up and have a look. It is a shoddy silver sculpture, a torso-sized piece of material sculpted into an artistic form. On this carving is the depiction of Tynan Bad Blanket Brock becoming madly, violently insane as a last step. On September the 7th, 5501, a single tear rolls down his face. The image somehow expresses both grace and deficiency. The subject are in front of a stream. Okay? You know what? Apparently a shoddy sculpture, but if it can convey this much information, I think it's probably bloody good. Right, Tamiz, you're going to go and feed someone. Okay, well, there are a number of things that we can focus on in this episode. I think some of them... Oh, these should definitely all be accepted. Let's go ahead and take those. I have no idea why we didn't already have those. That seems odd. Would you please go over here to me? I would like you to speak with the bulk goods trader. Additionally, I would very much like to add in a cooler to this area. Of course, the cooler should be pointing the other way, and we could then have a heater there as well. Then this area should actually be sealed off completely, and we'll have two very nicely temperature controlled rooms. Ooh, here we go. Right, I could sell them my gold. Don't want to. I would prefer to keep the gold. I could sell them some of my no, I don't think so. Okay, we've got a bunch of fodder that we can sell. We'll flat out sell that. We've already got 187 now. We're also going to sell a load of the wood. I think we will sell the boomrad leather. We've got a lot of anglefoot skill. I'd actually like to keep that. Human leather. 3.65. Wow. It appears that you could make quite a solid impact on any debt just by capturing people and selling their skin on the open market. That's actually a little bit... Well, that's a little bit terrifying, I'll be honest with you. Right, we've got a rooster. We've got a couple of female chicks. We've got another rooster. No, I think we'll wait until we've got more eggs. I think that makes a little bit more sense. Generally speaking, everything else is good. So yeah, we'll sell that on, get ourselves a little bit of extra money, hopefully move some things around. And you know what, let's have a quick look at how we've set things up. Currently, I believe we've got moss not dealing with handling very high priority, even though moss has a significantly higher skill with handling the most. I will allow Keegan to, well, I'll put Keegan on two. This way, Keegan and Shadow Wolf will still slowly improve. You can be on a four, honest. In fact, you know what? Let's not have you guys doing anything for now. Let's try and focus our handling on just a few people. Moss will definitely be working on that quite a lot. Additionally, wouldn't mind it perhaps if Moss would do some researching. You can do it if there's nothing better to do with your time. I'll have hauling, then research, then cleaning perhaps. Something along those lines. Oh, the ferrets. They're stirring. I would be surprised if they woke up. I just played with them for like an hour. So I imagine they're going to be out for the count for a little while. That all seems reasonably good to me at the moment. Though, that said, let's check on our outfits. Workers, you know what, I think I'll set up Moss as a well, we kind of got Archibald and Tamiz as soldiers. Keegan is a brawler. Willow Terra, I think I'll set you up as a soldier. I'm also going to clear all of the forced. I don't want people to be forced to wear things. Let's have a quick look. Selecting the outfits and just check these through. There's no particular requirements in so far as what they're equipped with. Okay, well, that seems reasonable. Right. Anything else going on down here? Personal shield has been discarded. That's not particularly good. I would actually like someone to wear that. Raymond, are you a brawler? I believe you aren't a brawler, actually. No. Ooh, someone is exhausted. Oh dear, Lazy Kim, why are you going all the way down here? That is going to be so bad for you. That is terrible. Lazy Kim moves so slowly. And they're now dazed. Oh, that's terrible. I feel that we made... as horrible as this is going to be to say, I do feel that we've made a slight mistake in taking Lazy Kim into our colony, honestly. Honestly speaking, I feel it was a bit dumb. We may end up regretting it. Okay, Moss has fallen asleep in there. What are you equipped with, Moss? Not much of anything. What kind of skill do you have? You've got a shooting skill of 4. Okay, you know what, Moss? I mean, we've got a Spiss sniper rifle, I suppose. But no, I'd rather you have the pump shotgun. You go grab that. What about Bad Blanket? You've got a gun there. Archibald's got a decent gun. You know what, Bad Blanket? I'm going to tell Bad Blanket to also be set up as a soldier. There we go. Now, the specific between a soldier and a regular worker is, I believe, headgear more than anything. And also the fact that they can wear armored vests and power armor. A worker doesn't wear these things. But honestly, is there ever going to be a time when I don't want a worker to have those things? I actually don't think there is. Realistically, I don't think there is. So perhaps I should just go through on Soldier and say, yeah, look, you can wear all of these things. You know what, let me have a look at Soldier, because I think Soldier is probably the better base. Yes. It looks like that is the better base on the whole. Dusters will definitely allow that. There we go, and then just change all workers to soldiers. But brawlers specifically are allowed to use personal shields, which is right there. Whereas soldier does not, so we're not going to have to worry about them not being able to shoot anything. So we've got, where's Shadow Wolf? You should also be a brawler. There we go, and we should be good. Right, Will of Terror, you're snoozing right now, that is fine. And generally, things are progressing rather well, all things told. However, I would like to have a look at, if I were to place this lamp, where would I need to place some supports? I think I've got a decent idea in my head now of where I need to place them. We're going to use marble. I believe it ends up being something like here, there. If we place it in the middle, just shy, just a little bit out. Needs to be one further south. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do with this is specifically, my intent is to have these supports allow me to place a roof over this area. We're going to want the door somewhere around about this location. And we'll have these all the way along as well. So, you know what? Let me just have a look there. So, you'd want one gap on each side. Then the fourth row along. I imagine something very similar on this side then. If we were to place that there. Yep. And we would allow for two gap on the far side. So that should all now be roughly set up to have these pillars at the very corners of the growing area. We'll go ahead and actually make them a little bit more interesting to look at though. So something like this. There we go. And this will then allow us to get proper roofed supports in this growing area. I think that'll be quite nice. I'm going to build out this rear wall with... Oh, we do not have any sandstone. That is a little bit of a pain. Is this set up? Yes, it is. Oh, okay. Well, we'll have to look into that. Moss currently doing a little bit of research. Thank goodness we've finally got things going. Oh, dear. Mr. Lazy Kim has lost their mind. Well, dragged. I mean, you didn't really have much of a mind there, I suppose. I mean, realistically speaking, you lost yours a long time ago. But we have all sorts of things out there that need to be hauled in. Okay, I'm quite concerned. To me, is there anyone out here that we can call? No, not particularly. That is very, very concerning. Okay, well, let's have a quick gander at what we can make here. Let's go ahead and make another sculpture. So, you know what? We could probably make wooden sculptures, honestly. That wouldn't actually be too difficult. Yeah, sure. Always keep do until you have... Let's not have until we've got 10. Let's have until we've got 5. That way we'll always have some wood sculptures to trade. There we go, fantastic. We're getting our marble walls in. Now we do actually have quite a lot of marble, so I suppose we could go ahead and build that out a little bit. But first I want to increase this up to 25 degrees there. Drop this one down to 18 degrees. That should be quite nice then. And we'll also pop in the floors. And the vents. Then these rooms will, well, eventually be okay. Right, starvation and exhaustion. Well, there's not a whole lot I can do for Mr. Lazy Kim. They're berserk. If I went down there... Oh, dear. You're really attacking a boomalo? I feel this is a pretty dumb move. How are you? Are we going to be able to recruit you? Probably not. Which is a shame. You're in prison, shared bedroom, feeling bad, naked. If we could improve these conditions, then I suspect we'd have a much better chance of actually getting someone to join us, but odds are fairly slight. So we're just going to try and flog a bunch of this stuff. We may possibly get rid of you. Oh, I would very much like another power claw. I would really like another power claw. I mean, wow, would I like another power claw. We're going to get rid of this. We're going to get rid of everything that's below 30%, which is pretty much everything in here. Sorry, below 60%. So all of those are gone. The sniper rifle, I'm tempted to keep. But at the same time, at 36%, it's probably not going to hang around for too much longer. No, we'll sell that too. And... yeah. It's expensive, so... There we go. Oh, no, that's not what I wanted to take. I wanted the power claw. There we are. So we're going to have to send them 760, but... That should be rather amazing. Where is Keegan? Keegan, you are about to get so massively upgraded. You currently have a power claw in your right hand. I now want you to have a power claw in your left hand. Install power claw, left hand. Oh, this is fantastic. We are literally turning Keegan into Wolverine. This is grand. Is that a good bed? I worry about that bed being the good one. Actually, on that point, I do kind of want to improve all of these. Also, I want to remove that seat because I just feel that it's frustrating Keegan to have people constantly coming into his bedroom to eat meals. It doesn't work well. Okay, one colonist awaiting medical operation. Poor mood. Raymond isn't too happy right now. I'm sorry, Raymond. Not sure why you're in such a foul mood, honestly. Right, well, are any of our doctors going to come down here? There we go, Archibald, well done. And I take it you're going to go and grab that fantastic device there. Oh, that's rather horrible sounds there. Right, let's have a quick look at Keegan. 2 power claws. Oh, this is going to be grand. Keegan no longer needs a weapon. Keegan is a weapon. This is fantastic. Melee of 12. Actually, Keegan's not a bad doctor. My goodness. Well done, Keegan. Seriously. We do want to get you an armored vest, though. And a better personal shield, too. Okay, well, things are moving on. Let's check on our animals as well. Melonhead is doing well. How about our wargs? How are you guys doing? Slowly working on training up the hauling ability for D.Va. Generally speaking, pretty happy with the amount of food that we have available to our animals. Oh dear. Lazy Kim, why? Okay, well, hopefully someone will go and get Lazy Kim. There we go. Well done, Archibald. I approve. And Lazy Kim is starving. Hopefully someone will feed Lazy Kim. Ironically, this is faster than Lazy Kim going and getting their own food, because they're so slow due to their brain injury. It is kind of hopeless in a way. We could try and sell some more things to the pirate merchant, perhaps. Let's see if we've got anything more that they'll take. We could sell the pistol. It's pretty shoddy. We'll also sell the Kevlar helmet. Likewise, pretty shoddy. The power armor might actually be good, but there's no way we could afford it. We could also sell the flamethrower, or rather the incendiary launcher. And I think we will. We'll get rid of that as well. Make back a little bit of money. We are actually fairly low on cash right now. How are we doing with research? We are still so far away from electric smelting. I'm frankly amazed by how long this is taking. Okay, is Keegan up and moving around? Yes, Keegan is. Ah, this is grand. Alright, let's check on Keegan's health. On an overview, he's only got 92% efficiency on manipulation because, you know, it's hard to have fine, dexterous manipulation of objects when you've got power claws. However, pretty useful for carving, I must confess. Now, we've got a raid. They are attacking immediately. Ooh, my lord, that is actually kind of scary. Okay, well, ideally I would like to attract them to this area, where we've got more of our weapons. Okay, everyone, you're all drafted. Lazy Kim, have you actually got any weapon? No, I'm going to undraft you. You're way too useless, honestly. Well, I mean, you're a brawler at the very least. Let me make sure that you're set up as a brawler. Okay. Lazy Kim, I mean, I am genuinely sorry to call you useless, but it's true. You're not the best fighter because you move so slowly. Alright, okay. Now, we want to... We're set up mostly for attacking from that direction. Let's get you down here. In fact, let's get our entire group down there if we can. Except for Willow Terra. Let's get you up there. I will also have Tamiz go up. In fact, Tamiz, you go there. Willow Terra, go down there. Tamiz is a bit slower, so it makes a bit more sense to have him there. Raymond, you go stand guard there. Everyone else move out. Okay, my weapons should be engaging at this point. Okay, there we go. Keegan, charge forward. Claws at the ready. Bad Blanket, get in position. Actually, get in position there. Awerty, you can also get in position down here. And Archibald, I want you over there, honestly. Shadow Wolf, follow Keegan. Moss, over here. Archibald, can you fire? You can, I think. Right, Keegan, go attack. Shadow Wolf, you're up next. Attack. Now, your shields should allow you to weather quite a lot of damage. Wow, Keegan, seriously? Blood loss, trivial, gunshot, improvised turret. You took a couple of gunshots and then a scratch from a power claw. Right hand torn off. Well done. I approve, Keegan. We could have you well, actually, you know, both of you, focus fire. We've lost one gun turret so far. Not great. It really isn't a good thing. Let's have you down there. Moss. Well, I mean, you've got a position now from which you can defend. How are things over there? One is already down. Want you in position, ready to engage. And move forward slowly here, please. Okay, one person needs a bit of help. Who is it? Shadow Wolf. You got a bruise. Oh, that's fine. Right, one down. Both of you, please. Move as one. Go for one at the front. Keegan is moving faster. Very nice. Attack one with the peeler. That seems to do a lot more damage, generally speaking. That's right. Take them down, please. There we go. Very nice work. Get up there. Do not allow them to escape. Take them down right now. Okay, Raymond, get out there. Tamise, you're in a good position to mop up some survivors. We want Will of Terror down here. And Archibald, you're still in a fairly good position. Moss, I want you to start rushing forward, please. There we go. Good work, Keegan. Very nice work. Keegan, get up there. You actually move incredibly fast. You may well catch up. Right. I would like it if you would get up here, please. Archibald, same with you. We are going to try and take down as many of these people as we can at this point. Right, Bad Blanket, you're up as well. Get up there if you can. Raymond. Right, they've made it out. So that's fine. We're not going to catch them. Melee attack. Gage. Shadow Wolf, you're doing well. Keegan is not quite catching up to them. How are you doing, Keegan? You got a couple of bruises. Well done, another one down. Okay, Raymond, engage. If you can slow them down long enough for Shadow Wolf to also get there. Ah, damn it, they're getting away. Cowards, come back! Oh well. You're all undrafted. Good work, everyone. Keegan, are you in a bad mood? What's wrong? Observed corpse, hungry, prisoner of soul, disturbed sleep, pessimist, ugly environment, in a little pain, feeling bad, uncomfortable, wounded, witnessed the stranger's death. Okay, yeah, I appreciate you've actually had a fairly busy day today. A lot of things been going on. So, yeah, alright. We could really do with a crematorium at this point. Okay, I will accept all of this. Oh man. Too many things. Take all of those, all of those. Spears, all the clubs. All of the people need to be stripped. Because, you know, we're going to sell each individual piece of clothing. That makes perfect sense to me. Okay. Well, you know, that could have gone significantly worse. And at the moment, we've got so much power, we don't need to worry about it too much. Seriously? Ah, you're going to grab the power. I'm not so sure I really want you taking that. I think I'd prefer Raymond having it. I know... Oh. Well. Alright then, I'll let you have it. Simply because it'll make more sense for you as a brawler, but you're never going to get any use of out of it. Let's be honest with ourselves. I'm just letting you have that because I feel sorry for you. Okay, hopefully we've got enough graves down there. We might not. There are an awful lot of people here to be dealt with. Well done on Keegan there. How's Tamiz doing? Left middle finger was cut off. Oh, I'm sorry. That is a bit rough, to be fair. We want you stripped. I mean, I could... I mean, that human skin... I don't know. This feels rather horrible. Okay, we've got a mad boomalope on his way to our facility. That's not so great. Got a couple of people with pretty bad moods at the moment. We really don't want Keegan to be particularly unhappy. A mad Keegan could result in death for our entire colony. There are loads of things just going wrong up there. Thankfully, Moss is taking care of a bunch of stuff. Well done, Moss. Well done. But on that note, I think we're going to wrap up this episode. And now that this field has been harvested, I'm just going to get rid of this entire grow zone and have them cut all of these plants. We are now going to start work on getting the dedicated night-long growing zones set up over here. That will be a big help for our colony, I think. But that'll happen in the next episode, so thank you very much for joining us. Oh dear. Oh, thank goodness Mr. Lazy Kim went berserk. Could have been worse. Could have been much worse. But on that note, do take care, everyone, and I shall see you next time.